sickle cell disease imposes a heavy burden on the quality of life of patients, both from the point of view of severe pain, number of hours missed from school or work, ability to be employable, and of course the long-term health impacts of this disease.
We know something about sickle cell disease. We've discovered a lot in the past 30 years on pathophysiology, clinical manifestation, but we all felt that we only see the top of the iceberg, and so a lot more needs to be understood.
There are richer countries, there are poorer countries, and there are different health paying systems. So understanding what was common to people who live with sickle cell across the globe and how we might work together to address those issues is very important.
All we're trying to do is to make sure that the quality of life is improved. And the quality of life as they perceive it, and quality of life as they feel it as well.
So what we found with the survey is that there's a lot more vaso-occlusive crisis happening than we've been able to capture from the typical way we look at vaso-occlusive crisis. We found that, first of all, patients don't always go to the hospital, handle a lot of stuff on their own, a lot of the pain on their own. About 5.2 crises a year for each patient, that's a lot.
For one reason or another, either due to a lack of treatment options or a lack of a quality interaction with providers in general, they're choosing to stay home and suffer. And so I would tell my colleagues, we need to do better. The patients are counting on us, and it needs to happen now.